Hi guys, my name is Joe Prusa. Unfortunately, we are making this video in the middle of a pandemic, but I want to tell you something about how we make personal protective equipment shields, which is in great shortage all around the globe, and how we manufacture it and distribute it here in Czech for our medical heroes. So now let's take a look how we make them on our print farm.
So right now we are on the print farm, where we have over 500 printers that normally print parts for other 3D printers. But now we have some printers dedicated to printing of protective face shields. In the building we have two other smaller farms, which we now also use to print face shields. As you can see here, this is a closed area, which can only be entered by trained operators, who must always wear protective equipment. Mask, gloves, everything disinfected. We also disinfect all contact areas around the printers. We try to minimize the manipulation with the parts and printers as much as possible. You know, use the knob to select the print, remove the print from the sheet, put it in the bag, close it, and yeah, that's basically it. What helps the sterility here is our air conditioning, which exchanges the air in the farm completely every 2 minutes. Additionally, during printing, the filament is heated to 265 and the heat bed to 90 degrees Celsius, so this in itself helps to sterilize the print. Every day I try 2 to 3 different print settings, or even different models. Our developers are constantly working on improvements. We try to speed up and streamline production, not only the print itself, but also the harvesting and restarting of prints. So there are various procedures before and after printing. For example, the print waits in a preheated state to prevent itself from getting cold, so it can start printing immediately. And another improvement is printing 2 to 4 parts stacked on top of each other. Then they just break apart like this, and we have 2 separate headbands. This maximizes utilization during the night, when there are no operators, so printers can just keep going by themselves.
Why face shields? So we were looking for some time what we could print on our giant print farm to help out. Already there were some designs in the community, mainly respirators. I don't suggest to print them because most of us use pretty hard materials, so it is almost impossible to get a good seal. And if you cannot verify a good seal, it is as good as a cloth mask. We've seen a great community design for the face shields. But I said that we want to do it the proper way, so I got in touch with Czech Minister, Ministry of Health, and the doctors, and we started to iterate the design. And in around 3 days, we had the final design and started producing. The face shields are great because they are an added layer of protection for the very large particles if the positive patient, for example, coughs. It protects the face and also extends the life of the normal respirators. This is our already third iteration based on the doctor's feedback, and we decided to publish it as open source on our Prusa Printers website. And I'm amazed and so proud of the worldwide 3D printing community, because in just a couple of days we've seen them being printed all around the globe and helping locally and helping the doctors. Thank you guys. I think the shields are a great addition to the other protective equipment the doctors have. And based on our feedback, we needed to make them pretty sturdy and very comfy, because the doctors wear them for the whole shift, which can take even 10 hours or more. So they need to sit really comfortably and copy your face. And also, as I said, they need to be very sturdy. Imagine emergency situation when patient has a heart attack, the doctors don't have time to think about their face shields falling off.
At this workplace, the laser plotter cuts out visors. They're made from PETG foil, 0.5mm thick, and we can make 40 visors from one sheet. Once the lasering is finished, the operator takes the parts and checks that they're not scratched. And then they're packed 20 pieces at a time, and vacuumed in a protective packaging. Those packages will be taken upstairs, where they'll be added to other parts in the complete package for shipping. At this workplace, we prepare elastic bands for the headbands. Originally, this single-purpose machine was used to cut the printer's textile extruder cable wrapping. But our developers converted it to this elastic band cutter in a matter of hours. It uses a resistance wire, the device moves the band to the correct length, and the wire cuts it. The operator simply counts the pieces and eventually changes the material spool. There was a problem, the rubber cutting produced a lot of nasty smell, so a developer came, added an exhaust originally used at another workplace, and the problem was solved. Here is the final assembly of protective shields. Printed parts harvested from the print farm are placed here, waiting to be added to the system. Then they are moved to packaging, where they are stacked in boxes with visors and rubber bands. This is another invention of our developers, who made a disinfection line over the weekend. Using ultraviolet light, UVC, it once again disinfects all the parts we produce. All bags are hanged on these printed clips, and they slowly go through the line. Then they're collected at the end, and they're put on a shelf marked as disinfected. And after that they go to packaging. We made 3 sizes of the packaging, depending on the boxes available. It really all happened in a matter of hours. We went to the warehouse, selected 3 boxes we normally use for our products, and made a packaging of 5, 20 and 40 pieces. The operator puts all the components in the box, adds a manual, closes the box, adds stickers and a date stamp, and it goes to expedition, where it's distributed to hospitals and others in need.
The shield is pretty simple. We use mainly 2 printed parts, the headpiece and the chin piece. This allows the securing to your forehead and needs to be pretty smooth. And the chin piece helps to keep the plastic rolled and makes it really, really sturdy. Also, the material needs to be pretty clear, because if you have it on before your face for a long time, it can really tire you when you are looking through something which is not very clear. And for the headband, you can use pretty much anything you find, but these hold elastics are very, very handy and makes it greatly adjustable.
Protective face shields for healthcare professionals are certainly a good protective equipment, especially for the doctors in the first line who come into contact with people potentially infected by the COVID-19. Then, of course, they are very suitable for laboratory workplaces where infectious material is being manipulated, because it is known that the disease can be transmitted not only through the respiratory system, but also through the mucous membranes and eyes. A plastic face shield can help protect medical staff from all of these, and it's a great addition to other means of protection. The feedback from our staff is very positive. They really like that the shields are light. The only remark we had is that people would appreciate if the shields could be lifted up on a hinge, but that's a technical question whether that's possible. But so far, after a day of use, we are satisfied with them.
Just recently, we released the stack version, which allows you to print overnight without handling the printer every 2 pieces. We also provided cap, which you can add, which increases the protection. And it is also very important that the cap for the top doesn't prevent the shield from bending, so it still sits greatly on the face. We also published a US version for a 3-hole punch and for the US materials, which is available online. And we are still collecting feedback from around the globe how we can make it pass in all the countries around. We also had a couple of Czech test labs to verify the proposed disinfection methods, and they were actually done with the live COVID. And because everybody knows that 3D printed parts can be porous, so we wanted to make sure that they really work. So So you can see them in the link in the description. So thank you everyone, stay home, stay safe, and print to share.
A 3D printer.
3D printing company.
This is the completed face shield.
7 to make face shields desperately needed by healthcare workers.
Třeba v tomhle případě 3000 kusů
denně, hezky česky.
Nevím, jestli se sem s ním vejdeme.